In this series of tutorials, we will learn how to design using brushes in Adobe Illustrator. And for first exercise, I'm going to show you how to draw a field of flowers. I will start by choosing rectangle tool, creating rectangle, and I will fill it with blue color, with no stroke, that will be sky. Then I'm going to take ellipse tool and create a large ellipse. I will fill it with green color for the field, and I'm going to keep things quite simple. Then I need to use some symbols to create brushes. To save some time, I'm going to use library symbols. I will go to Window, Symbol Libraries, Nature. And from Nature, I'm going to pull up some grass symbols. Then I will go to Window, Symbol Libraries, Flowers. And I'm going to add some flower symbols, like for example, a dandelion and maybe daisy. And I'm going to slightly rescale it. I will make grass a bit larger. And I will combine several types of grass to make graphics more interesting. And I will scale down flower a little bit and arrange my daisy. Something like this, for example. Then I will go to Window and open Brushes panel. I will select all the graphics I created and drop it inside of a Brushes panel. I will choose option Scatter Brush and click OK. And again, I'm going to click OK for now. Then I will select Brush tool from a tool panel. Make sure that new brush I created is active in my brushes window. And I'm going to start brushing. You're not going to get a good result at first, because this brush will need some modification. For next step, I'm going to select the flower and grass graphics I created. And even though it looks really complicated, if you will go to View Outline mode, you can see that technically I created several strokes. And I'm going to select them. And I'm going to deselect the sky and the field, because I'm only going to work on these few strokes I created. I will double-click on the scatter brush. Make sure you click Preview, and we're going to add some modifications. First, for size, instead of fix option, I'm going to choose option random, and I'm going to pull slider in one side to the left side and another side to the right side, which will give me differentiation in the size of the flowers. The same I will do for spacing. Instead of fix, I will choose option random, and I'm going to add different number of percentage for both sliders. And I will proceed the same steps with the scatter. Again, setting slightly different setting for both numbers. And for rotation, again, I'm going to choose random. And also for rotation, I will choose option relative to path. And I'm going to enter a very small value for rotation. And finally, I'm going to return back to the size and add some more modifications. So now my grass looks considerably more realistic, and I'm going to accept the settings and choose option Apply to Strokes. And now you will notice that every single stroke you're going to create will look more realistic. And very quickly you can create a field full of flowers. For next step, I'm going to add some clouds. So I'm going to return to Nature panel, and I'm just going to pull up some of the clouds. And to make things more realistic, I'm going to select them all. I will go to Effects, Option Blue, Gaussian Blur. And I'm going to add Slight Blur Effect. Just to make everything look more realistic. Finally, I want to frame my picture. To do this, I will select all my graphics and choose option Select All. Then I will go to Object Group. After that, I will choose Rectangle tool and create new rectangle, a little bit smaller than my graphics. And I'm going to fill it with white color. Then again, I'm going to select everything and go to option Object, Clipping Mask, Make. Now you can see that just in a few minutes you can create quite complicated design. For the next exercise, I will show you how to draw a tree. And I will start by creating a texture for the tree bark. I will find pencil tool and freehand will draw very rough piece of a tree bark. And I will fill it with dark brown color. And I will create another similar piece, slightly different in size and shape, but again pretty rough. And maybe one more. And again, I'm going to choose different shade of the brown. And if you want to get more realistic effect, you will want to create a couple of more pieces. I'm going to keep it simple like it is. And for next step, I'm going slightly downsize it, scale it down. And then again, I'm going to open my brushes panel and drop this graphics inside of a brushes panel. This time I will choose option Art Brush. And I will keep orientation from top to bottom. Now I can delete this piece. I will select brush tool and will make my first stroke. And you can see that looks quite realistic. So first I will start with stem and I will create several different strokes shaping my tree. To make the roots of the tree, I'm going to change size of a stroke to slightly smaller number, and I'm going to change the direction of my stroke as well. And the same way, I'm going to add some branches. At some point, I will change the size of the stroke again to a smaller number to create smaller branches. Sometimes your joints will be not quite as perfect as you want. However, you can fix it by switching on a main selection tool, selecting one of the strokes and simply rearranging the position of it. For next step, I want to add a very realistic sky. And to do that, I'm going to use a bristle brush. For convenience, I'm going to use layers. I will go to Window and find Layers panel. I'm going to lock my layer, create new one by choosing option Create new layer. I will bring new layer under the tree layer. Then I'm going to create a rectangle and I fill it with blue color. And perhaps another rectangle for the ground level. And second rectangle I'm going to fill with green color. Now I'm going to select brush tool. In the brushes window, I will select option create new brush. And I'm going to choose bristle brush and click OK. I'm going to increase the size of my brush So it's length. Adjust density slightly to negative number. Maybe add some thickness. And I'm going to decrease opacity down to 35%. And you can adjust stiffness. From flexible to rigid, I will change it to the flexible side. And I will click OK. Now again, I will select brush tool, set color of stroke to white. And I will set stroke value to 2 points. And I will try my new brush. And at first it looks a little choppy, so I'm going to modify it by double-clicking on a bristle brush I created and maybe adjusting size slightly. You will be able instantly to see the change. This way you can adjust your brush to perfection. And I will click on option Apply to Strokes. Now once my brush is adjusted, it's much easier to create cloudy sky. Also, if you wish, you can add more colors to your sky. For example, I can choose different shade of blue and make sky slightly more interesting. Maybe even a little bit of pink with reduced opacity. Now I need to add some leaves. And again, for convenience, I'm going to lock sky layer, and I will create new layer for the leaves. And again, I'm going to open nature library, and I'm going to find the green leaf, pull it out of the library, and then drop it inside of the brushes window, choosing option scatter brush. For now, I'm going to click OK to accept the settings. And after that, I'm going to select the brush tool, make sure that my new brush I created is selected, and I'm going to create kind of random path around this tree. And it doesn't look quite right away. So you're going to select your path and double-click on the scatter brush to open scatter brush options window. And again, we're going to randomize the size. Randomize the spacing, the scatter, and randomize the rotation. And for rotation, again, I will change setting relative to path. Then I will click OK and choose option Apply to Strokes. Now I'm going to create new layer above the tree. And I will create new path. And you will find out that it would be much easier for you to apply the leaves. So I'm ready for final step. I'm going to unlock everything. And I will choose option Select All. Then Object Group. Then I'm going to take Rectangle tool. Create new rectangle. And I'm going to fill it with white color. However, it's not critical what color you're going to choose. Then I'm going again, select all, and go to option Object Clipping Mask Make. And you can see now the result of graphics using 3 different brushes in Adobe Illustrator.